From my years of working as an audiologist, one of the biggest misunderstandings I see every day is when someone comes into my clinic and describes that they have tinnitus, ringing in the ears. They commonly ask me, what's wrong with my ears? Do I have something going on with my ears? And I have to explain that the source of tinnitus is not the ears, that the actual origin of the sound comes from the brain. In this video, I want to describe how ringing in the ears is actually ringing in the brain. If you have questions about why you have tinnitus, I want to use this video to explain the complex neuroscience to help you better manage your symptom and improve the ringing in your ears. This is Pure Tinnitus. Hey, my name is Ben Thompson. I'm an audiologist and founder of puretinnitus.com. Most people, when they try to fix their tinnitus, they're trying to look for a cause. The effect is tinnitus, so there must be a cause. And even if the hearing test is in the normal hearing range, typically the initial cause is the ear. The most important thing to take away from this video is that the tinnitus is not only an auditory phenomenon. If the tinnitus was just an auditory sound, then it would not take over our lives as much as it does. It gets feedback from the emotional centers of the brain. It gets feedback from the nervous system of our body. If we're feeling stressed, tight, if we're in an anxious state, fight or flight, then that sends messages to the tinnitus, which actually make it louder. Now just think about this. If you're having a hard time sleeping because of your tinnitus, then stress and anxiety, which affects sleep, will indirectly affect tinnitus. You don't have access to be able to pinpoint the tinnitus and turn down the knob to lower the volume directly. So the ways that you access the tinnitus are through the indirect pathways. This would be focusing on sleep, focusing on reducing stress, reducing anxiety, feeling more safe, feeling more calm, focusing on overall health and well-being. And it's also known that changes to diet can impact tinnitus, as well as certain pharmaceutical drugs that you take, which can affect the anxiety levels of the emotional brain, or it can affect the physical body. So it's clear that tinnitus is not only an auditory phenomenon, that it's impacted by other parts of our brain and by what we put in our body with our diet and our nutrition. Therefore, when someone finds me to work with me via telehealth for tinnitus, I don't only stay in the audiology or hearing domain. Of course, it's important with sound therapy and hearing aids, etc. But we also must focus on the whole person with the psychology, with the body and the nervous system to try to relax, to try to calm down, get back to our center. In the psychology, we focus on the fundamentals of getting into the root causes of stress related to tinnitus and anxiety related to tinnitus. The way to improve the ringing in the brain is by focusing on the psychology, focusing on the autonomic nervous system, as well as the auditory system itself. Now you know something about the neuroscience of tinnitus. Leave a comment below if you have considered working on stress, anxiety, or sleep to indirectly improve your tinnitus. And if you have so far, tell us what progress you've had so far. My name is Ben Thompson. Thank you for being here on my channel. Make sure to subscribe for all things tinnitus and hearing. If you enjoyed this video, check out this next video to my side. It's called, What is the Most Effective Treatment for Tinnitus? This video will go into all the details about the best practices and the evidence to help you. I'll see you there. Thanks for being here. Bye.